boy, this is good French pastry.
Ethel, there he is.
There who is?
Charles Boyer.
Where?
Right oh, here. Not again.
Honey, this is the fifth time you've seen Charles Boyer today.
That is the back of his head. I would know it anywhere.
In Hollywood, every guy you passed on the street was Clark Gable. In Paris, it's Charles Boyer.
I don't care. I have seen every picture he ever made. And if that isn't... Well, that's the way he would look if he had a beard.
The second tire of you and your imaginary Charles Boyer. I don't want to hear another word about it.
All right, all right. You don't have to get mad. I think he's jealous.
Lucy, are you going to finish that pastry?
No, go ahead, help yourself.
Fred, did you get the itinerary for Europe yet?
Yeah, we're going to stay over here in Europe a lot longer than we planned.
We are.
Here's a list of the places we're playing.
Someone who looks more like that man I keep seeing than anyone we've seen yet, look over there. Lucy, that really is him.
Well, it sure looks like him.
This time I'm positive. Come on.
Come on, let's get a photograph.
Right now.
Why? What's the matter?
You're not going to go over there.
Why not?
Because something awful is bound to happen.
Oh, don't be silly. What could happen?
I don't know, but I don't want to be embarrassed. You somehow or other seem to attract trouble.
Oh, give me one good example where I ever attracted trouble.
All right. We arrived in Paris. You went sightseeing, and we all wound up in jail as counterfeiters.
That could have happened to anyone.
All right. In Hollywood, you went to the Brown Derby for dinner, and Bill Holden ended up with a face full of pie.
That was purely an accident.
Van Johnson.
Well, that.
John Wayne.
That was not my fault. Come on, let's go. Come on.
Just a minute. You can't go over there like that.
Why? What's the matter?
You need lipstick, yeah.
Oh, I do?
Oh, you do, honey. We better fix your face up a little, huh?
He hasn't ordered yet. He's leaving.
I just wanted to get rid of them. I got an idea. I'm going to go over there and talk to him.
Yeah, let's go have a chat with
him. Sit down, will you? Two cornballs in this outfit is enough. Excuse me. I'm Ricky Ricardo.
Oh, yes, of course. How are you? I'm glad to see you. Sit down.
Thank you.
My agent cabled me about having lunch with you sometime this week. I was going to call you at your hotel.
Oh.
I think it's about doing some television shows in the States on Four Star Playhouse.
Yes, well, I didn't come over to talk business with you. I came over to warn you.
Warn me? About what?
Well, have you ever heard about my wife?
Oh, yes, yes, sir. Her name is Lucy, isn't
That's
it?
That's right, yeah.
Yes, yes, I heard all those publicity stories about her.
Yeah, well, I got news for you. Those were not publicity stories.
You mean they were true?
Yes.
Well, she must be quite a character.
Well, she's more than just a character. She's a...
Oh, yes, yes, we have a word for her in French. Balle de vis.
What does that mean?
Screwball.
That's the word. That's exactly the word. Well, look, she's coming over here to ask for your autograph. Play it safe. Tell her you're not Charles Boyer.
Well, she certainly can see that.
Yeah, I know, but she's already seen 10 men today that she thought was you. So just tell her that she made another mistake. All right, Charles?
Charles? But I think you made a mistake, monsieur. My name is Maurice. Maurice Dubois.
Thank you very much, Mr. Dubois. It'll be a pleasure having lunch with you later on
Goodbye,
the way.
Goodbye, Mr. Ricardo.
Thank you.